brothers and sisters. I want to welcome you back to life. Back to the one that can make your next chapter.
Thank you. I wasn't watching the engineer's window like I was supposed to. Now I'm looking up at the air sign on air. Praise God. Thank you so much for joining me this week. This is Pastor Natalie with Heart of Zion International Ministries. I am delighted to be here. When I came into the studio today, I told Elder Thomas, I said, he asked me, you know, as usual, how you doing or how was your work day or week? And I said, it's fine. I said, Thursdays is always great. I'm always excited on Thursdays because I know that I'm going to come into the studio in this, what's probably could be deemed as a prayer room, a war room, a room for discussing the things of God, the kingdom of God, a round table discussion for the kingdom of God. It is all that. And so I'm just delighted for today. And I thank you again for joining me. Today, I'm going to pray on air because the Father told me to right before the broadcast went on air, he said, I want you to pray on air. It is so desperate right now. There is such a need for the country to have prayer. There is a need for unity in the country. There is a need for unity in the body of Christ, and there is a definite need for, is that far enough? Okay. And there's a definite, I thought about that. And there's a definite need for, what do I want to say? Power to reign throughout the gospel, for power to reign throughout. For power to reign throughout the body of Christ, big time, in a big way. Because right now, I don't know how much, I would say the world's probably really not watching the church like that, except for the fact that there's so much, there's so much mixture. There's so much of a kind of a transfusion of the church and the world right now. Like we're sort of fusing together. And what needs to happen and what's going to have to happen is the body of Christ is going to have to get big time, begin to become audible. See, we've been audible, but we need to be audible by really obeying, really listening to God and really hearing from God. Because right now we've got, the church right now needs to kind of come up to come up to the timeline of God, because what God is doing right now, if you look closely, and I'm talking really to the body of Christ, especially to the body of Christ, if you look closely, look at the nations, okay? Don't just watch the news and, you know, be emotional about it. Right now, there is an atmosphere in this world. If you think about it, just the previous nations, Brazil, I think in France, we know the Middle East, there's always a lot of, conflict and activity going on over there. I'm trying to think of some of the other countries that have recently been in turmoil. You've got, Iran, the issues with Iran and Iraq. Turkey. Oh, there's in these past couple of years, there's been so much fighting and there's been so much of a breakdown in the government. Have you noticed that? There's been a breakdown in the government of other countries. Now we can, you can get political with that and say, hey, some believe the breakdown comes from, a society that yields itself to socialism. Which many say is communism. Socialism and communism run hand in hand, or one is just a different name or term for the other. There's many reasons why a country can fall apart, can crumble, okay? It does it from within. It does it from within. And there has to be a couple of elements that are involved. It's going to be division, fighting, disagreement, deception, lots of deception. And deception can come by way of our government. It can come by way of leaders. It can come by way of governmental parties, you know, whether you're Democrat, Republican, or whatever. It can come by way of local senators, local leaders, local civil leaders, just, you know, politics and religion, like I was talking about last week, is such a sore subject because politics and religion always express and manifest the core values of where a person is, you know, what's in their soul regarding people. And if you think about it, politics and religion all have to do with people issues, okay? Politics, how you're going to run the government, how you're going to treat the people, how the people will be supported or taken care of, how you will run your society. It's everything is a people business when you think about it. Everything in this earth is a people business. Anyway, so the Father told me to pray and I am going to obey. Hallelujah. I hear you, Holy Spirit. He told me to pray and I am going to obey. And so I have an idea what I think the Holy Spirit's going to speak through me, but I know right now we need so much unity in the body of Christ and we need so much focus. We need to refocus because there's too much focus on self-glory. There's too much focus on some of the things that we think are successful for the kingdom of God, for successful for the body of Christ, you know, which is large churches or prosperity in the church, you know, physical, I should say material prosperity. So many things. Okay. The Holy Spirit is telling me, just cut it out. And I'm gonna start praying. Okay. Father, in the name of Jesus, Father, you see the state of the country, America, whom you have given as a blessing to the people. And we know it is a blessing to the people because so many people come from other countries and they come here seeking freedom of religion, freedom to worship as they please, freedom to live as they please, freedom to speak, freedom of speech, freedom to live their life the way they desire, whether it is wrong or it's right. Father, there's so many reasons that people come to this country. And we know, Father, that you have had your hands upon this country. And so, Father, right now, in the past several years, while there's been so much upheaval and so much conflict and contention and disarray and dismay and hopelessness and poverty and wars and battles, Father, in the surrounding countries, in the name of Jesus, Father, we're asking that you would put your hand upon America, and especially, Father, your children here in America, that our eyes would be open, that scales would fall off our eyes, and we would stop looking at what's right in front of us and look at what's going on around us, Father, in the name of Jesus. Father, I pray that you would open your children's eyes up to the commandments that you gave us that would cause prosperity and success and life to come our way. And that is even the blessing of Abraham in the name of Jesus. You said, Father, when you made that covenant with Abraham, you said, I will bless those who bless you and I will curse those who curse you. And so, Father, please make it plain to the people, especially the body of Christ, Father, those that are promoting your will and your agenda in the government. Father, in the government, whether they like them or not, whether they are pleased with the character or the presentation or the disposition, Father, of the people that you have in leadership, Father, open your eyes for your children, for those who are following your plan, Father, those who are following your plan to make this country great, Father, those who are following your plan that follows life, Father, those who are promoting life, Father, not those who are promoting death in the name of selfishness, Father, Ikerabohanda, killing babies, Father, Ikerabohanda. Father, wake up your people so they can see, Father, Ikerbohanda, those in leadership that you are using to promote your agenda, Father, to bring prosperity to the country, Father, to bring freedom of speech, Father, to your people. Ikerbohanda, Father, expose those that are trying to shut the mouth of those that believe in your word, those that promote the gospel, those that stand by the God of the Hebrews, the God of Israel, the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. Father, in the name of Jesus, expose all those that have been fighting to shut the mouth of your word spoken in this country, Father. Wake up your people, wake up your children, Father, so they can see clearly, so they can have 2020 vision in 2020, Father, for those that are promoting, Father, your agenda. I say it again, those that are promoting your agenda, Father, in this country, open their eyes, their spiritual eyes, Father, that they may see and even stop fighting amongst themselves, Father, that they would follow the lead, Father, of those that are trying to hear your voice, that are doing your will, whether they are pagan kings or whether they are those that are your leaders that you have set in pulpits, Father, in the name of Jesus. Father, I pray in Jesus' name that the body of Christ in America would wake up and follow the gospel. Follow the Old Testament, Father, the promises that you've made for those that support Israel, Father, in the name of Jesus. Father, we're asking in Jesus' name, Father, that you would heal our land, Lord Jesus. Heal our land, Father, that we would humble ourselves, hallelujah, and come to you, Father, and look to you and ask you, Father, what is your plan? What are you doing? What are you saying? What theme are you trying to show us? What is it you're trying to show us about this great nation of America? What we should be doing, where direction we should be going in, who we should be listening to, who we should be following, Father. I ask you to heal the hearts and the minds of those that are offended and they can't see past their offenses in the name of Jesus, Father. We're crying out in this land, Father, for you to open the eyes, open the eyes, open the eyes, open the eyes of your children so that they can see what you're doing. Open the ears so that they can hear your voice, Father, and go in the direction to follow those, Father, that you have set in positions of authority, and speaking of authority, in the name of Jesus. Father, I ask that you would expose and pull down every person that's seated in a position of authority in the government, in the White House, in the name of Jesus, in the Senate, Father, in the Ketabohanda, Father, in the different parties, Father. Expose all those that are against your will, that are against the kingdom of heaven. Hallelujah, Father. Show the real heart, Father, of the people that are sitting in positions of authority and that are fighting against you, that are fighting against your will being done in government, that are fighting against those that you have placed and seated in a position of authority. It is you who sets up kingdoms and you who takes down kingdoms. You cause kingdoms to arise and you cause kingdoms to get deposed. So, Father, in Jesus' name, I'm asking that you expose every filthy, dark thing that the enemy is doing in our government, Father, in the name of Jesus. It's to Okorapohanda. The people are so confused now, Father. We don't know what to believe. We hear one thing and then we hear another. And everybody says they're telling the truth. Everybody says that their way is the right way. So, Father, we ask you in Jesus' name to open the minds and the souls of your people so that we can discern where truth is coming from, Father, and to get our flesh out of the way, to get our emotions out of the way, Father, and to hear what thus saith the Spirit of the Lord. That is my prayer in the name of Jesus, Father. Whatever your Spirit is saying, that the people will not be in any confusion anymore and not be in the darkness anymore, Father. Expose all those that are in darkness in government and in leaders of position in Jesus' name and let them, deceit them, Father. Deceit them, Father, and remove them who are against you and against your plan and against your will. in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Lord, and praise you, Father. In Jesus' name, let it be done. I present this, Father, this petition to the court of heaven, Father, in the name of Jesus. Rule, Father, rule in these petitions, Father. We're asking that your will be done in Jesus' name. Amen. 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 I know you probably heard a lot of repetition in what I was saying. I kept asking my heart, this is my soul, kept asking the Lord to let his will be done, to let his will be done, no matter what we think and no matter what we choose to believe. The Father's will needs to be done in this country. We need to know, we need to know and be able to discern truth. My God, I've never lived in such a time that there's such a desperation to know truth, because everybody's saying they're telling the truth. We hear about fake news. I saw that ABC now has a slogan on theirs calling it straightforward news. And there's just so much. Everybody now, we can see things are crumbled. You see how things crumble when it is left up to the complete or the sole authority of mankind? Because when the people are left to be influenced by man and man alone, what happens with that is we're going to be influenced by the convictions of that person. And the convictions of that person that are over major networks, news networks, that are over major government, major areas of government and officials, the convictions of that person are going to manifest through the platform that he has, whether it's through the media, social media, news media, or the government, okay? And so that's why, more than anything, we just need to be asking God to reveal to us truth. Father, who is telling the truth? No matter what I believe, especially if we find out what we're believing was in error, ask God to show you. Don't try to hold on to your own impressions of what you think is going on around you. Get down on your knees and in your prayer closet and cry out to the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, and ask him to reveal who is telling the truth, who is doing his will. I talked to you last week about how God used pagan rulers. Some were pagan, some were set up, some were descendants of the children of Israel, and they still went left. They still went left. And so what we really need is we need someone in office who is going to be in office. And I mean, not just the presidential, not just the top office of the chief executive officer of the country, and not just the leaders of Senates and the leaders of Democrats or politicians or, the other parties that are involved. I can't think of it right now. But in the name of Jesus, I'm telling you, we need truth more than anything. We have got to ask God, the body of Christ, you have got to ask God to reveal truth, truth. We know where truth comes from. Truth comes from Yeshua. Yeshua said, I am truth. That is where truth comes from. So we really need for God to give us some discernment on who we need to be following. We need to be following those that are following God. Okay. Last week, like I said, when I talked to you about pagan rulers, and I don't think I went into some of the things, or I may have, some of the things that has been accomplished since President Trump has been into office. Now, I know this is a sore subject because there's such dismay and there's such a conflict and contention about our commander in chief. And so all I'm asking you as a Christian, as a believer, what is being done under this man's command that is in agreement with the word of God, that is in agreement with God's agenda, that is in agreement with prosperity for the land, that is in agreement to bring harmony to the land and amongst the people, okay? And so, one of the things I wanted to talk about here, I mentioned last week, I mentioned several kings to you. I mentioned Josiah, I mentioned Xerxes, I mentioned King Saul, I mentioned King Solomon. Tonight, I'm going to talk for a few minutes, however much time I have, a little more about King Cyrus. Now, King Cyrus, I didn't know this until tonight. King Cyrus was succeeded by King Darius. Okay, I knew that their kingdoms were together. I believe one, if I'm not mistaken, and you scholars out there will know, I believe one was the descendant of the other, that Darius was the descendant of King Cyrus. Okay, but this is what I didn't know. As Cyrus started this plan, remember the Jews went to him, the leading Jews that were truly following God and hearing from God at that time. It's in the book of Ezra. Okay, and said, we want to rebuild our temple. And so King Cyrus gave the Jewish people, or gave the Israelites, okay, the permission and the support that they needed to rebuild the temple. Now, there was another sect that came to the, I'm trying to think of the prophet's name. There was another, maybe it was Ezra. Okay, it must have been Ezra, because it's the book of Ezra. Okay, let me see this. Who did Cyrus call to rebuild the temple? Glory to God. It must have been Ezra. Hold on, y'all. Okay. So I'm trying to see who the prophet was at that time. Zerubbabel. Ah, Zerubbabel. Okay. In the book of Ezra, yes, Zerubbabel was the governor of Judah. Okay, and he laid the foundation for the temple. Praise God. Now, this is what I want to get to. So, okay, it was just, I had to know that Zerubbabel. Cyrus gave Zerubbabel and his constituents the permission and the finances and everything that they needed to rebuild the temple. But there was a sect that came against them, and I can't remember the name. Okay, y'all can go to the book of Ezra. Start at Ezra chapter 3, okay? And that will take you into the chapters after that, all the way up to about chapter 7 or so. We'll give you that account of what happened. But what I wanted to emphasize tonight was that God used a pagan king, King Cyrus, and that gave permission and support to the Jews to rebuild the temple. Now, this group that came against Zerubbabel and his constituents and the other children of Israel that were rebuilding this temple, they were angry because when they came to Zerubbabel and said, hey, we want to help you, we want to take part in this, and Zerubbabel, by, I'm believing, conviction or word of the Lord, because I didn't get a chance to read everything, okay? So that's going to be my homework too, told them no. No, you will not help us to rebuild this temple. And so they got mad. And what they did was they went to King Cyrus. They conjured up some letters. They got some letters together. They did a little studying. And they went back and said, hey, look, King Cyrus, these people that you've allowed to rebuild this temple, they've been troublemakers, basically. He said, they've been troublemakers. We have seen in their history that their people have come up against the reigning kings and, you know, had revolts against them, rebellion against them, these same people who you're giving permission to rebuild this temple. Now, this was a God-ordained project for the temple to be rebuilt. And so, you know, the enemy will always stick his ugly head out, whether he do it through government, whether he do it through an enemy nation. He is always going to fight against the ordinances and the projects and the assignments of God. And so that's what you had. But my point in sharing this with you, and there's so much more to it, Cyrus ended up listening, by the way. He believed these people because they did come to him with some letters that they had dug up in the archives about the Israelites rebelling against kings. Mind you, we know just from the Old Testament that the Israelites were rebelling against kings that wanted to consume them, that were against God, okay? And they would only get punished. God would punish the Israelites when the Israelites would turn to worship false idols and false gods. That's when they would get punished. But when they would repent and turn and do God's will, God would begin to bless them, and the children of Israel would begin to flourish again. And so back to this King Cyrus. So this King Cyrus was influenced by this wicked group of people that came to him and got him to take the permission away, to take away the permission that he'd given the children of Israel to rebuild the temple. So the rebuilding of the temple was halted for a while. Okay. And so then later King Darius came into prominence, and King Darius, the matter was taken up again with him, and the children of Israel began to rebuild the temple again. And at that point later, you know, as time progressed, they were able to rebuild the temple. My point is this, the enemy will always come up with a plan, because he's not stupid. Okay. He's stupid for getting kicked out of heaven. That is the stupidest thing that anybody could ever do in the whole creation, in all of creation, is to get kicked out of heaven. But he's not stupid in wickedness, when it comes to the Bible refers to the wiles of the devil. I believe it's in the book of Ephesians. And so what we need to do is to really understand how the enemy works. Okay, he is strategic, but his strategy is always wicked. It is always going to be against the plan of God. It is always going to be against the move of God. And so that's what I'm saying to you, and I'm encouraging you and pushing you, so that the body of Christ right now can begin to push back darkness. Darkness is really trying to pervade the land, okay? And so I'm telling you, what we're going to have to do is come together in prayer closets, come together in prayer vigils, start opening the doors and having some all-night prayers again. I'm telling you, we need to come, the body of Christ needs to come together in agreement, and everybody stop trying to succeed in their own glory of their ministry. You know what I'm doing. In other words, get the focus off of trying to build your ministry, because God will do that. God will build our ministry. If he has called you and he's given you assignment, then he's going to do that. Just like I'm depending on him to do that for me, to build the ministry if I have something to offer. And I only have something to offer if I'm in the assignment of the Almighty God. If I'm obeying him, then I have something to offer the body of Christ. And so this is you would say a clarion call to the body of Christ to come together in Ikerapohanda. Come together. And begin to seek the face of God and ask God, what is he doing in our government, in this country? What is he, what does he want for Israel? Because don't you find it strange and unusual that Netanyahu, Prime Minister Netanyahu, and President Trump have been going through the same kinds of resistance and rebellion in government, trying to depose at the same time? And yet, if you look, President Trump has been on the side of Israel. Okay. So I know some of you are saying, hey, you're just trying to promote the politics of President Trump. No, I'm trying to say, please hear God, ask God, go to him honestly and find out what he's doing. Ask him to show you, Father, who are you using? What is the truth about what you want for America right now? And don't forget to fervently pray for the peace of Jerusalem. And right now, Jerusalem needs harmony. They're having their third election with Netanyahu, and I forget how to pronounce this other contender's name. They're having their third election. And really, they're trying to get Netanyahu out of office and bring in this other contender. But I'm telling you, ask God what he is doing, what he wants to do. Pray for America. Pray for Jerusalem. Pray that God reveals his will. If you can't remember anything else that I said tonight, ask God to reveal his will for the country we live in, for this great country of America, and for Israel, for the nation of Israel, the state of Israel. Okay? And ask God to show you in plain sight, Lord, what is your will? What do you want me to do? Even if it comes to Even if it comes to dismissing some beliefs that you've had up to this time, or some support, or some opinions or perspectives that you had, all I'm saying, ask God to show you what it is He wants for this country. For this country affects the state. The state affects the cities. The cities affect the community. And the community affects the household. It all affects us personally. And we really need to know what God is doing. I hear my music coming up. And so it's coming that time. I'm going to ask you to pray for me. Those of you who have sincere prayer for me. And I'm going to pray for you. Okay, I'll be praying for listeners. Ask God to show you what it is He wants you to see about this country. May God's face shine upon you. May God have His grace upon you. May He give you peace. Hallelujah. And bless His holy name. Okay? God wants the best for us.
That's why.